Hello students, today I'll continue the topic pox viridae. As you know that pox viridae is a virus family and it contains the large double-stranded DNA viruses with complex symmetry and they cause diseases in humans as well as in animals. These includes two subfamilies, Cordopox virini and Entomopox virini. Out of that, Cordopox virini causes infections in humans and animals and in the lab animals. So coming to the genus of the Orthopox virus, cowpox virus, it causes cowpox and its reservoir host is rodents. Means in reservoir host, the virus do not cause any disease, but it helps in the spread of the disease to the other animals. And from the reservoir host, virus occasionally spreads to the domestic cat, cows, humans, and in the zoo animals. But the names cowpox means the cowpox virus infection in the cattle is comparatively rare or extremely rare condition, but sporadically it can occur in the enzootic areas. And it produces lesions on the teeth and the contiguous part of the udder, means the adjacent part of the udder to which teeth are attached. And it can spread to the other animals in the herd through the process of milking. But the cowpox virus infection is in cats, it is rather more severe than the cattle and than the humans. And infection may be systemic. And in the cats, small papules appears on the head or the forelimb that eventually ulcerate and cause lesions. That ulcerated lesions dry and forms scab formation, and complete resolution of the lesions occurs in about 6 weeks. Few animals may get the signs of the coryza, means the common flu-like or cold-like symptoms or the conjunctivitis. Sometimes it also causes pneumonia and pleural exudation develops in the cats. And diagnosis of this cowpox virus can be done by histopathology or electron microscopy or through the virus isolation. Coming to the genus Parapox virus, the Parapox virus genus have different viruses and it affects wide range of the species. And generally it causes cutaneous or mucocutaneous lesions and these are zoonotic in nature. Viruses are ORF virus, which are also have different names, contagious ecthyma, contagious pustular dermatitis virus, pseudo cowpox virus and bovine papular stomatitis virus. Coming to the ORF virus, or it is also named as contagious ecthyma or contagious pustular dermatitis virus. This causes the disease ORF, and it is also having different synonyms. Disease is having synonyms of contagious pustular dermatitis, contagious ecthyma, sore mouth, yeah, scabby mouth. It is an important disease of sheep or goat, and it mainly affects the young animals of these species. Camels and humans are also susceptible to the infections, and the virus transmission occurs through the direct or indirect contact. Under dry conditions, in dry environmental conditions, viruses are stable and can survive in scab materials for the months, which acts as a source of infection to the other animal. Coming to its pathogenesis, virus entry occurs through the skin abrasion. And virus is epitheliotropic, means virus is having affinity for the epithelium and there it produces proliferative wart-like lesions. And it replicates in the epidermal keratinocytes and infected cells release and endothelial growth factor, which is involved in the proliferation of the epithelial cells. Lesions develops in different stages. First, it develops in the papular lesion. Papular lesions means just as tiny skin eruptions. Then it forms vesicles. Vesicles means the tiny eruption which is formed now it gets filled with the serous fluid. Then pustules. Pustule means the eruptions get filled with the purulent material, and they eventually to forms the scab formation. Scab formation means the lesions get dried, exudate dry, and it causes crust formation. And the proliferation of the cells underlying the scab produces varicose masses. Varicose masses means the lump of the masses, small lumpy material or wart-like elevations it causes. And the secondary, in the absence of secondary bacterial infections, lesions usually heal within the 4 weeks. Coming to the clinical signs in the lesions, incubation period is generally up to 7 days, and the seriously affected animals may lose weight and get predisposed for the secondary bacterial infections. Morbidity is high in the young animals, but the mortality is usually low. But if the buccal cavity lesions are severe, which may prevent the lambs or kids from the suckling, or it may prevent to take food, then the mortality rate is high. Coming to the symptoms and lesions, lesions are mainly seen on the commissures of the lip, means the on the junction of the upper and the lower lips, and on the muzzle. Lesions also develops in the mouth and affects the gums, palate, and tongue. Sometimes lesions also develop on the feet, genitalia, and the teats. And if the lesions are very mild, it may go unnoticed. See, this slide shows the picture of the orc. Lesions are seen on the lips of the lamb. In the second picture, it shows the orc lesions in the goat. And in the mouth, lesions are seen. And it also, as I told, that this is of genotic importance. So human is also gets infection, and it causes lesions on the humans also. Diagnosis based on the characteristic appearance and the distribution of the lesions is helpful for the diagnosis. And the virus can be isolated and identified by electron microscopy from the lesions. There is no specific treatment, but the use of the antibiotics can reduce the effect of secondary bacterial infections. And in endemic areas where the flocks are affected, control is done by the use of live vaccines. And ewes are generally vaccinated before the lambing, and non-attenuated commercial virus vaccines are available, obtained from the infected scabs or from the virus grown in the cell culture. Coming to the next virus, pseudo cowpox virus. It causes pseudo cowpox and is generally a reason for the mild teat lesions in the milking cows. And the infection, transfer of the infection can occur through the use of teat cups or on the milker's hands, or also mechanically by the flies. And it produces characteristic lesions of the horseshoe-shaped scabs or ring-shaped scabs in the center heels, and it produces characteristic this shoe, horseshoe shaped scabs. See, here in the picture it is seen, and it can be done by the demonstration of the virus, typical virus, cocoon shaped or oval shaped virus, and from the using of the electron microscopy. Its control involves the appropriate hygienic measures, the milking or including the use of teat dips, and it is also zoonotic and causes milker's nodules in the human. Next is bovine papular stomatitis virus, and disease known as bovine papular stomatitis. It's also spread by direct or indirect contact, and it causes mild papular lesions on the mucosa and the oral cavity of the young cattle. Virus can be demonstrated in skin scraping by electron microscopy, and it is also transmissible to humans. Coming to the genus ABPOX virus, ABPOX virus includes the viruses of the poultry, and it includes the pox, fall pox, and other avian pox viruses, pigeon pox, turkey pox. And these are named on the basis of the their host for them. Viruses are having affinity or from the host from which they are recovered. But the fall pox, pigeon pox, and turkey pox viruses are closely related and not strictly host specific. So from one species to another species, virus transmission may occur, and mainly the mechanical transmission of the virus occurs through the orthopods, especially mosquitoes, which lead for the transfer of virus between different species of the birds. Fall pox virus, as I told, it can affect apart from the fall of other species of the birds also, and it is highly infectious for the chicken and turkey. And turkey virus is, apart from turkey, it is also virulent for the ducks. Apart from the fall pox virus, other avian pox viruses infections are typical causes, typically cutaneous lesions, and in canaries. Canaries is a singing bird which in which systemic infection is very common and produces 80 to 90% mortality. Coming to the fall pox. Fall pox is a disease of domestic poultry, chicken or turkey, etc., and it is caused by the fall pox virus. Infection is slow spreading, and factors such as malnutrition, debilitation, stress may contribute to the severity of the disease. Infection may also persist as a latent infection, and reactivation by the stress may occur in few birds. Fall pox disease occurs in two forms: cutaneous forms, which is also known as dry pox, or diphtheric form or wet form of the fall pox. Cutaneous form, it is the most common form of the fall pox, and it results from the infection of the biting orthopods or mechanical transmission to the injured or lacerated skin occurs. Nodular lesions develops on the comb, battles, and the unfeathered part of the skin. Occasionally, lesions also develop on the legs and the feet and around the cloaca. And these lesions are nodular type. They become bluish and then progresses to a thick, dark scab. And these lesions often coalesce, means they come together to form a mass of the lesion. And then the formation of the skin, if the lesions are around the skin on the nails, then it may cause nasal discharge. And if the lesions are on the eyelids, it may cause lacrimation and predisposes poultry for the secondary bacterial infection. In severely affected birds, lesions may involve the feathered and unfeathered part of the skin also. And if the lesions are on the eyelid, it may cause the eyelid to come for the complete closure. In uncomplicated cases, healing occurs within weeks. Next is the diphtheric form of the disease, or wet pox. And it is mainly caused by the droplets or by inhalation of the virus. And it, in this type of the pox, it involves the infection of the mucous membrane of the mouth, pharynx, larynx, esophagus, and sometimes the trachea. Yellowish necrotic lesions develop, which are also known as cankers. And these lesions coalesce and result in the formation of necrotic pseudomembrane. Pseudomembrane, on the mucous membrane, a thick layer forms, false membrane develops on the mucous membrane, and which may block the trachea or cause death by the asphyxiation. Oral lesions also.
Ma'am, could you please mute everyone?
Oral lesions interfere with eating. Tracheal involvement may lead to the labored breathing and the rales. Rales means the abnormal lung sounds are heard. When the poultry is involved, is having cutaneous infection, it causes little mortality and flocks return to the normal production on the recovery. But the diphtheritic form, mortality is high and it may reach up to 50% in outbreaks, or especially when the pox infection is also associated with secondary bacterial or fungal infections. But the recovered bird of the pox viruses are immune to the subsequent pox virus infections. And the economic losses in the fall pox is due to the transient drop in the egg production in the laying birds. If the laying birds are affected, then it causes lowered egg production. And if young birds are affected, then growth is affected, which no uniform growth in the poultry flock, and ultimately leads to the economic loss. Coming to the diagnosis, large intracytoplasmic inclusion bodies are formed, which is also known as Bollinger bodies. Bollinger was a scientist. Otto Bollinger, it was a German pathologist, which bovine actinomycosis, all of you know the actinomycosis, and also he described inclusion bodies in the tissues of the fall pox. And so the inclusion bodies of the fall pox was known as Bollinger bodies. And these inclusion bodies contains finely granular or filamentous material in the center of the inclusion. And these are known as elementary bodies or also the Borel bodies. Other method of the diagnosis are immunofluorescence or immunoperoxidase technique. Immunofluorescence means the antibodies against the fall pox are reacted in the antigen in the tissues, and these antibodies are binded with the secondary antibodies which are having fluorescence tag.
Amrinder bhai, mute kar lijiye.
Fluorescence is detected.
Ma'am, voice clear nahi aa raha hai.
And by this method,
ma'am, sabko mute. Hello.
All should mute your voice. Then otherwise, here also some sounds are coming. In immunoperoxidase,
कहा चल गया, कहीं लगता है मैसेज तो कर रहे हैं.
इन इम्यूनोपरऑक्सीडेज एचआरपीओ मींस परऑक्सीडेज इज टैग्ड ऑन द टिश्यू एंड विद द एंटीजन. In immunoperoxidase, thin slice of the tissue is fixed on the glass and it is incubated with antibodies, which is tagged with the peroxidase, and then chemical substances or substrate are added to it, which develops the color, and the distribution of a stain is examined in the tissue and by this, antigen of the tissue are detected. Virus particles can also be detected from the electron microscopy, or the for the diagnosis, virus can be isolated in the avian cell culture on the coriolentic membrane route. Avian cell culture, or also on the coriolentic membrane of the 9 to 12 days old embryonated eggs. Other tests are ELISA, viral neutralization test, agar gel precipitation test, and passive hemagglutination test. पैसिव हीमोग्लोबिनेशन टेस्ट मींस द ऑन द आरबीसी आर एब्जॉर्ब टू द सॉल्युबल एंटीजन ऑन द सरफेस एंड देन दीज आरबीसी एग्लूटिनेट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ एंटी सेरम विच आर स्पेसिफिक फॉर द एंटीजन. So in this sensitized RBC are used. Other method for the diagnosis are PCR. And the diphtheritic form of the fall pox is more difficult to diagnose as it may cause infection in the absence of a skin lesion. And the diphtheritic form of the infection can also be confused with the infection of the deficiency of the vitamin A, pantothenic acid, and also with the toxicosis and several other respiratory diseases caused by the viruses. Coming to treatment and control, there are no treatment, but the secondary bacterial infection, control of the secondary bacterial infection is desirable, and the endemic areas, improved management, hygienic condition, along with the regular vaccination is used to reduce the effect of the disease. And for this disease, modified live fall pox vaccine or the pigeon pox virus vaccine are available, which are produced in avian cell culture or in chick embryo, and these are commercially available and used for the control of fall pox. Thank you.